Okay, here we're filming, changing the oil pressure sensor on the Impala SS. And what happens is if the sensor goes bad, you get a service engine soon, and then the car will always stay in the V8 mode. And also the remote starter will not work. So here you can see the service engine soon light comes up, and to fix that we're gonna go and change the oil pressure sensor. Let's see if I have it here. Now the oil pressure sensor costed us about $91 with taxes here in Winnipeg. It went to like a little over 100, I think 105 bucks or $110. So once you change it, you should be able to remote start the car, and also it'll switch from 8 to 4 cylinders and back and forth. And we'll show you exactly how to do it. It's very simple, it's about 5 minutes operation, and the service oil surface engine light should go out. Now, one thing you want to do is you want to make sure that it is the actual sensor that is defective and not your oil pump. Because if the oil pump breaks, you will have no pressure, and the sensor will detect that and lights up. So by changing the sensor, nothing will happen. So what you can do is get an oil pressure gauge and put it where the sensor is, and start the car and see. It should give you about 50-55 PSI. Then you know your pump is okay and the sensor is defective. We're just gonna gamble and just gonna change the sensor, because I mean, it's a piece of crap and I know it's gonna break. So I think the pump is fine, and if the light still stays lit, then what I'm gonna do is go get the gauge and put it in and start the car and see if there's no pressure. Then it's a different operation. What you have to do is go under the car where the oil pan is, open it up, and it'll be just right there, and you can change it, and we'll put up another video on how to do that. So let's go out. It's freezing snowy in Winnipeg, and it's very, very cold, and the car's outside. So we're traveling right now, so we have to do it outside in the freezing cold. But well, here it goes. Ready?
Ready as we'll ever be. Let's rock.
Okay. And turn off the engine when you do this. All right, let's go. Just before we go outside, here's the actual sensor, brand new. So that's how it's going to look like. This part, the aluminum part, is going to get screwed on the engine block. And this part up here is where you're going to plug the electrical connection. So this comes off. And you can see right here, you have 3 pins electrical connector. And it's going to be sitting like this on top of the engine block. And we're going to go, and I'm going to show you exactly where it is. And it's like a really 5 minutes operation to get it out. Now you might need, actually you will need a deep well wrench, a deep well socket with a wrench. And one thing to note, the threads on this thing is very cheaply made, and it's aluminum, and they'll break very easily. So do not torque it with the wrench, tighten it with your hand. I'm going to show you exactly how to do it, and it should form a very strong seal. So here's the engine for the Impala, and it's exactly right there. So to know it, this is the air intake. That's like the front of the car. So you go to the air intake, just follow it. That's the air sensor right here. I don't know if you can see it. And follow that, and it's just like right there. You will not miss it. It's just right there. That's it. That's the actual oil pressure sensor, and on top of it, the electrical connector. Once you remove it, you'll see it. And then you have to put a wrench and take it out. Okay, Kisra, if you can hold the flashlight for me while I do it. Okay, so here's my socket wrench box, and I'm gonna try to fit what fits in here. I hope I have it. It's just fucking freezing. Fucking walls. Nothing fits this thing. Damn. Crap. Okay, that's a problem. And here's the sensor. I unplugged the electrical wire, so you can see it looks exactly like the one we bought. This one, it just has like yellow color. That's where the wire goes in, and you need to open it down there. On the base, you see that little thing. You just screw it open, and it'll come out. That is the sensor. It took us like not even 30 seconds to pull the wire. Could you hold the light? Just hold the light. Strength to find the wire I pulled. Alright, see, this is the wire. That's the wire. It has like three pins that's gonna go on it. So just move it aside and now use the deep socket wrench to reach it. So here's another view of the engine compartment to see its location. You see how? It's just down there. Very, very simple to do. And we're doing it in minus temperatures. There's ice everywhere and it's dark at night. And it's going to take us less than 5 minutes. So it's not a difficult thing to do. I think anybody can do it. Here, to give you an idea where it is, that's the front of the car. And I just put my wrench down, so it's just right there, and it doesn't take a lot of effort to screw it open. Just make sure your engine is off, otherwise you'll have oil spewing everywhere. And here we go. Could you hold the light? I'll see if I can hold the camera and open it. There you go, that's open. And here it is. We took it out. Here, give me the camera, actually. This is it. And this is where it was sitting. I don't know if you can see it. Let's see. I'll try to get it. There you go. It was sitting down there. Just make sure there's no dirt that can go in. Put the new one in place of the old one. This is the old one. We're gonna go get the new one and put it in, and you're done. Here, maybe you can film me putting the new one. Here, hold it. And hold the flashlight. That's Operation Redneck. More like Operation Idiot.
Who does this?
So, here it is. I don't know if they can see it. That's the old one right here, and that's the new one. They're exactly identical. Let's make sure you remove this little piece of plastic, and well, don't throw it, don't litter and do like me. So just make sure you throw it in the trash. So that's the new one. Let's put the new one in and see what happens. Actually, I'm gonna screw it by hand. Can I have the flashlight? You can hold the camera. Let's see if I can reach it. And make sure it goes in straight. That's very, very, very important. You don't want to screw it in at an angle, because then it's going to start leaking and you'll damage the treads, and it's going to cost you a lot of money. So just take your time and make sure you put it in like straight. Okay, let me have the flashlight somewhere. Oh, that's even better. Balls. All right, there we go. that one in. Now, there it is. I just screwed it in by hand. That's the new one. So now I'm going to use the wrench to tighten it with my hand. Do not torque it, remember. Don't torque it, just tighten it with your hand. Make it tight, not too much, and never torque it because the threads will break. It's made out of a cheap aluminum. And there you go, you can finally do it. You have it. So what I say don't torque it, I mean don't do this. Like don't go like this and then start pushing it hard, because it's not supposed to go hard. There you go. That's in. Now let's put the wire. Let me just That's the 3-pin wire. You can't miss it, you have to line it. It won't go in unless it's aligned, so you cannot screw that up. So just align it and you should hear a snap, a click, basically. Okay, here it is. I put it in, and actually this is the electrical wire. It went in, and that's the little latch there. You probably can see it, let me zoom in. There it is. That's the wire, and that's the latch, and it snaps when it goes in. And that's it. This is it. We're going to start the car, and the service engine light soon should disappear. Hopefully. If it doesn't, then that means it's the oil pump. That's another video. Hopefully it's not. Because it's so cold, and it's fucking balls. Here. Wait. Put the lights. Let's take all this stuff out before something falls in there, and then we make another video on what we broke. All right, that's it. Let's go. Now, once you install it, start the engine and inspect for leaks. Very important to see that what you did, there's no leaks, and I don't see any leaks. It's really dry. Let me see if I can show you. There it is. So there's absolutely no leaks. It's running fine. And it's good to go. So now your service engine light soon. Service engine light should go off. And the remote start should start again. And it'll switch from VA to V4. The displacement on demand should start working again. It won't get stuck only on V8. And there you have it. If you have any questions, leave a comment.